check out Rob's new art. Red alert, John, shine a light down on the front lines of my mind. Paint the Rob way.
Challenge that I occasionally face when I've done a few paintings of someone is how to make the new one something fresh. I don't want to get repetitive or tread ground that I've thoroughly covered. My last Becky Lynch portrait played off of her steampunk look, and I felt I had said what I wanted to say with that for the moment. I was talking about it with my wife, and she had a brilliant suggestion in that I work from Becky's Straight Fire war cry. With that, everything clicked into place. I'd make her a fire elemental, which would give me a lot to work with. I took inspiration from one of my favorite comic book artists, Steve Lytle, who actually drew the cover of the first comic book I ever bought and is a fellow Kansas Cityan. He had a particular way of drawing the X-Men's Dark Phoenix, where the fire was flickering off of her that always fascinated me. He also did a high contrast cover with her where he used red and yellow instead of black and white, and that's where my whole idea came together. So I first did a layer of yellow as my base and then worked up my layers from there, getting darker with each one as that's the way to work with watercolors. Watercolor is pigment mixed with water, and then the pigment stays when the water dries. They're thin layers that are mostly transparent, so you have to work from light to dark, because once it's dark, you can't lighten it back up. In this case, I went from the light yellow to the deep red to get the fire effect I was after. So where do I get my ideas? For this one, it was Becky Lynch screaming Straight Fire in the ring, a conversation with my wife, and a comic book cover I saw when I was 8 years old. And there's the finished piece. Not bad.
Buy it now!
Black and blue, I crawled along. The wreckage of what now is gone. Back to you to fight.
Latino Heat!